إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. We often raise our hands. We supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we should. Supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes, there are some people who supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they say, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. And then when the response does not come, they say, Ya Allah, why are you not responding to me? That's not the question that we should be asking. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the dua, the supplication of a person will be responded to as long as he's not in haste. And what is that, being in haste? It's saying, Ya Allah, why are you not responding to me? But the question that we should be asking is, why are we not responding to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because when we respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to us. When we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we fulfill the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we quickly respond to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in Surah Al-Baqarah, بَعْدَ نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي If my servants ask you about me, O Muhammad, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ Surely I am near. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ I respond to the one who calls upon me when they call upon me. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He says, I respond to the one who calls upon me. When he calls upon me, then Allah says, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي. But let them respond to me. I mean, let them make the commitment to respond to me. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do something, we quickly fulfill our obligations and respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without procrastinating. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond to us. Then let us respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it's time to pray, we don't say, inshallah, after the show is over. Inshallah, after an hour later. No, when we're quick to respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do something, we do of it as much as we can, as quickly as we can. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ وَسَارِعُوا. Be quick, be in haste to the paradise, to the forgiveness of Allah and the paradise of Allah. Be quick when it comes to doing good deeds in the hereafter. When it comes to seeking the bounties of this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمْشُ فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُوا مِن رِزْقِ. Walk in its path and seek the provisions when it comes to the dunya. When it comes to the hereafter, be quick. When it comes to doing good deeds, be quick to respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to you. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Let them respond to me. Let them have faith in me so that they may be rightly guided. That's the correct path, the right path. And so, whenever we're in need of anything, big or small, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always there. Return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you have any concerns, anything that concerns you, any distress, any sadness. When you go around complaining to people about your problems, when you go around complaining to people about your problems, seeking sympathy from them, most people, the majority of people don't care. And even if they do, they just say a few words here and there. I'm not saying that if you have problems, you don't go to people who are able to help you. But first and foremost, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and address your concerns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam had found out that he had lost, of course, he had already lost his son Yusuf. He had already lost his son Yusuf for many years, in fact, for decades. And this was at the end of his lifetime. And then he found out that Binyamin was also gone, and he was in Egypt. And then the eldest son, some of the scholars have mentioned these were the three most beloved sons of Prophet Ya'qub. If the first was not enough, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the second also. For those who don't know the story of Yusuf, you can review it. Prophet Yusuf, and then Benjamin was stuck in Egypt also. And then the eldest son also exiled himself. So he did not come back with everybody else of all the 12 brothers. Only 9 came back. And Prophet Ya'qub supplicated and supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until his eyes, until he became blind because of so much incessant crying. And he mentioned, he said, Ya Asaf ala Yusuf. Whoa, the sadness of the loss of Yusuf. وَبْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ. And his eyes became blind. وَهُوَ كَذِيمٌ. But he held it back. That means he was patient. Did not go around complaining to other people. And so when his children heard it from him, heard this from him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَتَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ. He turns away from them. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, the Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam, turns away from his children and grandchildren and his family. And he says, Ya Asafa ala Yusuf. Oh, the sorrow of the loss of Yusuf. That turning away is mentioned here. It's very important. Because he's not complaining to them. He's not complaining to them. He's not speaking to his family. He's addressing his concerns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's how a believer is. Even amongst people, he's always connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. And so his children, they said, قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ تَفْتَأُ تَذْكُرُ يُوسُفُ. By Allah, are you going to continue to remember Yusuf? حَتَّى تَكُونَ حَرَضًا أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْحَالِكِينَ. Are you going to continue to remember Yusuf until you become old and weak and feeble? And so, Prophet Ya'qub, he says, قَالَ إِنِّي قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Indeed, I am only addressing my concerns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, he turned away from them. He's not complaining to them. And of course, he says, I only address my concerns, my sadness, my sorrows and sadness and distresses to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you're feeling sad, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth. When you're in financial difficulties, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He is the possessor of all the treasures of the heavens and the earth. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you're feeling sick, for it is only He who can cure you. It is only He who can cure you. When you're having family problems, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for indeed it is He alone who can change people's hearts, for He's able to do all things. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. Surely I turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I address my concerns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But does that mean that you If you need help, for example, you're at the hospital and the doctor says to you, how are you feeling? And you say, Alhamdulillah, I'm doing fine, even though you have a headache. Like, no, it's okay to speak to someone about problems that you may be having. If they're able to help you, there's nothing wrong with that. But don't go around complaining to other people, seeking sympathy from other people. Instead, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always near and He will always be there for you, inshaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always there. And when we seek, when we supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with us. When you go to people often and keep on asking from them over and over again, they become annoyed of you. Sooner or later, maybe the first time they'll help out, the second time maybe they'll help out, and maybe even the third time, but sooner or later they're going to get annoyed of you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry at you. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. Whoever doesn't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is angry at him. And that's why supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every little thing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even said, supplicate and ask Allah for every little thing, everything, even for salt. If you need salt, something as simple as seasoning in your food, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala possesses all things, and He can give us everything and He can take it away also. Be appreciative of what are the things that you have and supplicate to Allah even for your shoestrings. As the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, your shoestrings, when they break, supplicate to Allah, because when you supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you in this world, or will save it for you for a later time that's more appropriate and better for you. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep it for you in the hereafter, and in that case you would wish that every dua in this world was not accepted, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you in place of it in the hereafter. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will alleviate from your calamity that would have befallen upon you. So every time you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you always win. Continue to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah." Dua is ibadah. The essence of ibadah, of worship, is dua, is that supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also mentioned certain times that we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. And amongst them is a day like today, Jumu'ah. On Friday, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, indeed, inna fi yawmin Jumu'ah lasa'ah. There's a time period on Friday that anyone who supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during that time period, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from him. And the majority of the scholars are of the opinion that it is in the afternoon of Jumu'ah. And some scholars have mentioned it is between the time that the khatib sits down between the two khutbas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our dua and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا. There are some people in this world, there are some people who say, oh Allah, give us the goodness of this world. وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقًا. But he will not have any share of it in the hereafter. He will not have any portion of it in the hereafter. Some people, they just make dua for this life only. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِينَ عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And then there are some who say, oh Allah, give us the goodness of this world and the goodness of the hereafter and save us from the hellfire. This dua that Allah taught us in the Qur'an, this is one of the dua, the supplications that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made often, over and over again, as Aisha radiallahu anha and many other companions mentioned. And this dua teaches us one other thing. When you're supplicating to Allah, there's nothing wrong with supplicating for the goodness of this world. رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً. Supplicate, remember. When you're supplicating, remember to supplicate, of course, for this world. Of course, most of us, that's the first thing we supplicate for anyways. And it's okay. But don't forget the hereafter. So supplication should be divided into three portions, as we're taught from this verse. The first is supplicating for the goodness of this world. And then the second portion, the other third, is to supplicate for the goodness of the hereafter. And the last third is to supplicate and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save you from the torment of the hellfire. So if you're supplicating to Allah, don't forget to supplicate for the hereafter. Don't forget to supplicate for the other believers, for your parents. For indeed, when you supplicate for others, the angels, they say, and for you the same. And for you the same, and they're making dua for you. The noble angels make dua for you. So maybe your dua, maybe there's certain things in relation to your dua that may not be accepted, but maybe the dua of the angel is accepted. And when you're making dua for your brothers, other Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that. Because the angels, inshallah, the angels, they say, and for you, they're making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغدا واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are certain etiquettes. As I mentioned, Jum'ah, also one of the best times to supplicate to Allah is in sujood, when you're most near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the best times to do so is in the last third of the night, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the lower heavens. And one of the best times to make dua is when you're waiting for prayer between Jumu'ah, between the Adhan and the Iqamah. But also, your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very, very important. You don't want to break that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you have to also be very careful of that which you put in your mouth, the wealth that you take in. Where you got it from? Is it from halal or from haram? You have to check that. Why? Because when you're taking things from haram, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said there was a man who was traveling. He was bishabud ash'ath aghbar yamud yadayhi ila sama. He was bishabud. On a long trip, his clothes were dirty. He raises his hands, and you know that a traveler, someone who is in that condition, a traveler's dua is accepted. But this man raises his hands and he says, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, wa mat'amahu haram, wa malbasahu haram, wa ghudhiya bil haram, fa anna yustajab. But his clothes is from haram. And his food is from haram. He's nourished from haram. And how is he going, how is it going to be accepted? That's why you don't want to disconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because, you know, with electricity and things, electronics, when you pour water, everything short circuits. Don't short circuit your dua by putting haram, pouring haram into your body. That short circuits your dua. You want your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue. Be careful of what you put in your mouth. Be careful of what you put in your family's mouth. Be careful of the wealth that you take in. Be careful of what you spend and how you spend and where you're spending it also. You don't want that to be connected, because if you don't have Allah, then you really have no one. Who is there to help you if you don't have Allah? Who is there in the heavens and the earth who will help you if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not help you? Who will answer your call if Allah does not answer your call? And that's why, be quick to respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And make sure that your source of income is halal. You don't want to short circuit your dua. Allahumma fir al-muslimina wal-muslimat wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwa وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وأقيموا الصلاة. استووا واستقيموا اعتدلوا سووا صفوفكم تراصوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى
النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم.